DJ ATV.
Gunmen kidnap Miyeti Allah's chairman as parents of abducted Kaduna students protest to National Assembly. Plus, Senate postpones meeting with service chiefs and IGP as Atiku Abubakar calls for the recall of air servicemen to help tackle insecurity in Nigeria. Hello, great viewers. A wonderful morning to you, a wonderful afternoon to you, and a wonderful evening to you, depending on the actual time. The time is now that you are watching us now on our ever informative day-to-day news update on your one-stop darling TV station, DJM TV. I am Stanley Okocha, yours sincerely, reading the hot news trending now for your informative pleasure in Nigeria and around the world at this time. The chairman of the Miyeti Allah Cattle Breeders Association, MACBAN, in Nigeria, Alhaji Wakili Damina, has been kidnapped by unknown gunmen. This was made known to newsmen by the secretary of MACBAN, Mr. Adamu Abubakar, in Lokoja today. According to him, Alhaji Damina was kidnapped on 30th April 2021 by some armed men dressed in army camouflage. He also said that eyewitnesses said the abductors, numbering about 8, stormed the chairman's house at Chikara village in Kogi local government area of Kogi state at about 12 noon in a white bus. He further disclosed that he was let in the know about the incident after about an hour by the younger brother of the Miyeti Allah's chairman, who witnessed the incident, noting that he immediately tried calling the missing chairman's phone number, but it rang out with no one picking. However, the Miyeti Allah scribe said Alhaji Damina's number was switched off after he repeatedly called the number after about an hour later. Since then, his lines are not reachable and all effort to know his whereabouts have all failed, he said. When contacted by our correspondent in the state, the Kogi State Commissioner of Police, Mr. Ede Ayuba, confirmed the incident and stated that the police is yet to locate the whereabouts of the kidnapped chairman. The Kogi police boss added that immediately he was informed by the incident, he immediately put a call across to the MACBAN's chairman's phone lines severally, but there was no response. The commissioner, however, disclosed that efforts to get detailed information about the incident from the divisional police officer, DPO, in charge of the area where the incident took place has proved unsuccessful, as the matter was not officially reported at the divisional police station overseeing the area. Also in the news, the parents of the abducted students of the College of Forestry Mechanization, AFAKA, in Kaduna State have protested to the National Assembly complex. The protesters, which included members of the Student Union Government, SUG, of the institution, lamented over what they described as the negligence of the state and federal government in securing the release of their children and students. In the protest, they chanted solidarity songs and displayed different placards asking for quick rescue of the students. Placards displayed by the protesting parents and other concerned citizens had inscriptions such as, "Education is our right, safety is our right, freedom is our right, free AFAKA 29. The parents and students chanted as they marched to the entrance gate of the Nigeria's National Assembly. Meanwhile, the protesting parents and students were joined by the publisher of the Sahara Reporters, Omoyele Sowore and Deji Adeyanju, who had gathered at the Unity Fountain before marching to the National Assembly complex. The main entrance of the National Assembly was, however, guarded by security agents who denied the protesters entrance into the National Assembly, and the protesters occupied the entrance until the deputy clerk of the National Assembly, Mr. Bala Muhammad Labani, came out to address them. Speaking with the protesters, Mr. Labani pleaded with them to be peaceful and told them that their grievances their petitions will be taken and forwarded to the leadership of the National Assembly. And he assured them that the National Assembly will, as a matter of urgency, look into their grievances. Meanwhile, the Nigerian Senate has announced a postponement of its earlier scheduled meeting with service chiefs, the Director General of the Nigerian Intelligence Agency, NIA, and the Inspector General of Police, IGP, to Thursday. This was made known today by the Senate President of the Nigerian Senate, Senator Ahmad Lawan. The Senate President stated that the security chiefs are still engaged at the National Security Council meeting, which may extend to tomorrow, being Wednesday. In the Nigerian Senate President's words, "The briefing will be very crucial for us to be properly informed and properly guided. The only item on the order paper on Thursday will be the briefing," he said. However, after an exhaustive debate at the Senate plenary on Tuesday, it was resolved by the Nigerian upper chamber to invite the heads of the nation's armed forces and other security agencies over the current security challenges facing the country. Senator Lawan also stated that the Senate leadership will meet with President Muhammadu Buhari to discuss the worsening security situation in the country. Still in the news, the former Vice President of Nigeria, Alhaji Atiku Abubakar, has told the federal government of Nigeria to consider recalling former servicemen and women who are willing to return to serve in a bid to use their wealth of experience in tackling the insecurity situation currently ravaging the country. In a series of tweets through his verified Twitter handle, Atiku Abubakar said that the security situation in the country is deteriorating, with Nigerians now living in constant fear. He noted that terrorists are fast spreading their areas of operation beyond the northeast into far-flung areas as far as Niger State in the north central, which is nearly hours from the federal capital territory, Abuja. In the tweet, the former vice president wrote, "Now is the time for decisive leadership, and I call on the federal government to consider recalling all air servicemen and women who are willing to return to service and to take the fight to the insurgents until they are rolled back and defeated. As a former vice chairman of the National Security Council, I am aware that Nigeria has a sizable population of military veterans who are alive and were trained locally and internationally, and it serves no purpose to allow their valuable national assets lie fallow when there is an existential threat to our nation. Call them up immediately. Mobilize them to the field. The time has come for us to put in all our effort and stamp out this menace from our nation. The men and women of Nigeria's armed forces, whether serving or retired, who restored peace in Lebanon, Liberia, Sierra Leone, and Sao Tome and Principe can and should be used to do same in motherland." The tweets read, "The presidential candidate under the People's Democratic Party, PDP, in the 2019 presidential elections also pointed out that there is need for the provision of arms and ammunition, adding that it is the responsibility of the federal government to develop a more efficient means of sourcing for weapons and delivering them to the troops at the battlefront." In the tweet again, he wrote, "When our military is properly rewarded, they will fight more valiantly and gallantly. A nation that rewards courage is one that avoids outrage," he added. With that news report, we have come to the end of our day-to-day news update for this time. We really want to appreciate you, our dear viewers, for always being there and staying tuned to all our news video each time we broadcast them. We equally plead with you to kindly like, share, and comment on this news video that you have just watched. Also, we equally ask you to kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel at DJM TV. And once you have done that, kindly hit your finger on the notification bell to always get alerted each time news broke and we broadcast it for your viewing pleasure. Until the next news video, where I'll be coming your way again with another news that would have broken out at that time, I am Stanley Okocha for DJM TV News. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next news video. Bye-bye for now. DJM TV.
People are living for doesn't know, they don't like us.
Welcome to DJM TV.
Some of the delegates are asking the question.
DJM TV.
Let's get
DJ.